हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू प्रैक्टिस सम मोर क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू डायमेंशनल एनालिसिस। आर एप्लीकेशन वन इज चेकिंग द करेक्टनेस ऑफ गिवन रिलेशन। इन दैट वी हैव डन टिल नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 7। नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 8। हियर दिस क्वेश्चन इज लिटिल डिफरेंट, सो लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड। हियर इट इज गिवन द फॉर्मूला न्यू मीन्स फ्रीक्वेंसी equal to 1 by 2L root T by M. Okay students, so this it is looking like V but it is nu. Nu means frequency of vibration. Okay, the meanings will always be given of the formula. Now we have to check that this formula is dimensionally correct or not. Let us understand the meanings of all the symbols here. So let us read. L is the length of a string, T is the tension in the string. Tension means a kind of force which is always in the string, stretched string or rope. M means here not mass, M is mass per unit length. Now this point you have to notice that M is mass per unit length. Now as we proceed to check this relation, then we can first solve the right hand side. So let us start firstly with the right hand side. We have the formula 1 by 2L root T by M. This 2 is not taken because 2 is a constant and constant is always ignored whenever we replace the quantities with their dimensional formulas. So 2 is dimensionless. Then we have remaining 3 quantities. Okay, first, second and third. Now we will do what? We will replace each of the quantity by their dimensional formula. So L is length. Its dimensional formula is capital L. Now here T, this may confuse you. This T is tension. So this T is tension means force. So we have to apply the force dimensional formula only, which is, I think you remember, it is M1 L1 T minus 2. Okay, so remember, if only tension word is written, that means it is force. So you will write it M1 L1 T minus 2 formula. Okay, then this tension T is different from surface tension. Okay, so this tension T is force. If surface tension is written, then its meaning is different. Surface tension meaning was force upon length, but only tension meaning is force. Okay, now next term is M written here. Now generally for M we substitute capital M dimensional formula, but that M is mass. Here M is not mass, here M is mass per unit length. So how do we solve the dimensional formula of M? So let us solve it separately here. Small m is mass upon length, so M upon L. So it will finally become ML minus 1. That's why in the formula here we have written ML raised to power minus 1. Then we have root. So root means we have to apply power half. So let us start cancelling the similar terms here. So you can see M is getting cancelled. L is not getting cancelled. L has different powers. So L power 1 and L power minus 1 in the denominator, numerator, they don't get cancelled. This L raised to power minus 1 will get shifted to numerator and its power will change. It will become plus 1 on going up, and already L raised to power 1 is there. So L2 it will become. Now L2 T minus 2 power half, that means L1 T minus 1. Take a copy and solve this step yourself. You will understand. Then this L is getting cancelled because 1 L was already out. This is the one which was out. So finally we are getting T raised to power minus 1. Okay, so right hand side answer is T raised to power minus 1. Now what is on left hand side? On left hand side we have frequency. So frequency, its dimensional formula is T raised to power minus 1 only, because frequency means reciprocal of time. So this way we have got that right hand side and left hand side answers are same. That's why this formula is dimensionally correct. So here in this question, the point to be noted was First of all, every time m meaning is not mass. So m meaning here is written mass upon length, and accordingly only we have to go. And new term you have seen here, that is T. T means tension. Tension means a kind of force. Let's solve one more such question in which we have to check dimensional consistency. But this question is in form of cos theta, trigonometric function. So how do we deal with this type of question? Let us understand. We have to check again the dimensional consistency, that means dimensionally correct or not. Let us see the meaning of all the terms in the question. H is height, S is surface tension, rho is density. We read it rho, okay? It looks like P only, but density means rho. R is radius, G is acceleration due to gravity. Now we have to check this formula. Is it dimensionally correct or not? So let's start. First of all, on the left hand side, we have H. H means height. So what is the height's dimensional formula? It is L. So easily we have written L. This is the answer on the left hand side. Now let us look on the right hand side. Right hand side formula, 2S cos theta upon R rho G. You can clearly see it here. Here it may not be visible properly, but here it is written 2s cos theta upon r rho g. Now what to do for all these terms? 2 is a constant, so ignore it. Then cos theta, that means trigonometric function, it is also dimensionless, so ignore it. That means only s is left in the numerator, and s is surface tension. Surface tension formula, basic formula is force upon length. So you can calculate from force upon length. So you can take the help of that table also which we have drawn for the dimensional formulas of all the quantities. So surface tension is m1 t raised to power minus 2. L is missing here. Okay, L doesn't come. So m1 t raised to power minus 2 is the dimensional formula for surface tension. Okay, now next. R is the radius. Radius is length only. Okay. Rho is the density. Density's formula is m1 L raised to power minus 3. G is the gravitational acceleration. So any kind of acceleration has always the dimensional formula. L1 T minus 2. Finally, we will cancel the similar terms. So you can see M is getting cancelled. T raised to power minus 2 is also getting cancelled. Now only L terms are remaining, so L power 2 and minus 3. So L power minus 1 will be left in the denominator, it will shift up, it will become L power 1. So this is the last is the RHS answer, and LHS answer is also the same, so this relation is correct.